Okay, everybody, I'm the American Spirit, Russell Blade here. This is a live program we're doing where all of us, one of my good friends here, getting together to chat about some of our favorite wrestlers who's been mainly like superheroes to us because we watched them a lot on TV, and everyone knew one of my favorite superheroes back then was the Ultimate Warrior, one of them. Travis, what? Who were you? Who was your favorite superheroes in wrestling of all time? See what you can think of, and just bring it up.
I remember Hacksaw Jim Duggan was one of my favorites as a kid. He was
damn
great.
The one with the 2x4.
Yeah, 2x4 and American flag,
and yelling around. Oh, I remember that one.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, this guy's wrestling all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. And whenever you see the old videos, even on YouTube nowadays, it kind of does bring back childhood memories. They really do.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Oh, really, yes.
I really like watching the throwbacks. That really.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it does. Mm-hmm. Those throwbacks. Yeah.
And speaking of my childhood memories. I mean, I gotta say Hulk Hogan. Gotta say Hulk Hogan.
Oh, definitely. Hulk was pretty good, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh. Charlie and that microphone he's got, it was given to him by a friend of his that does that little echo. Oh, there he goes.
Right.
Doing commentary right now. Go for it, Charlie. Let's hear your commentary. Shoot. This is pretty cool shit, man. Yep. Oh, you remember one of the most hated villains of all times? I remember the ones we didn't hardly care for, like old Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase. He was a villain. I remember those days. I used to hate him when I was a child because he was always with that little, oh, I got lots of money. His laughter. I'm like, what the hell? I remember those times when I was a kid seeing all that. Oh, man. So who was your most hated villain, the ones you can remember?
I don't know which one would be my most hated villain. I'm trying to think back of one that aggravated me the most.
Yeah. Just take your time to go back, dude.
I don't know about old time, but I can tell you one that used to get under my skin recently. And I like the guy. It's Randy Orton. He used to aggravate me.
Oh, yeah.
But
he kind of had talent.
Oh, Randy Orton's great.
Yeah, he actually.
Yeah. Charlie, you don't like Randy Orton? Nope.
Doesn't seem like he does. I'll tell you.
Nope.
A lot.
Boo.
Yeah. Hey, he's got talent at playing a villain, though. He really does.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, he plays it well.
Yeah.
And the funniest, he can flip script. He can flip script and play an excellent hero as well.
Yeah. Yep. I remember going to most of these live events, like some of the ones in DeSoto, some of the ones in DuPont, Illinois. Mm-hmm. We would go to these shows, and some of the wrestlers, they knew how to taunt the crowds to get them angry at them, the villain parts, the villains.
Oh, yeah.
It's funny, though. I would notice how they
– in its own.
I would notice how they kind of try to cover their face like this or that. What they're trying to do is hide that shit-eating grin on their face because they know they completed their job of getting the fans all angry where they're saying what they think and all that sort of thing. They try their hardest to hide it, but still, I notice that every time I'm watching them live in the ring.
Right.
They always, it's surprised, though, they don't catch that on camera where they're hiding that shit-eating grin on their face because they It's the funny part.
I hate to cut you guys off short, but I got to get my little man ready for bed.
Just come back another time, be a part of our live show. We'd love to hear from you.
All right, buddy. Good to talk with you guys.
Have a good night.
All right. Good night.
Good night. Yeah.
Well, almost good night.
Well, looks like we got one good guest on our show. Heck yeah. Yeah. So far, so good. Oh, yeah, I know that old theme, The Undertaker. I remember that good show. Oh, I remember last time we went.
I remember
all the words we used to say that would taunt the villain wrestlers and stuff. I remember I yelled out to one of them saying something like, "You wrestle like a bum," and he would try to hold down the second rope saying, "Come on, I'll give you 5 minutes in the ring. Come on, let's go." Like, you think I'm that stupid?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If I was, yeah. I also remember, who was this other guy we've seen? Oh, yes, the big monster, the troll. And I remember, and what's funny is I was the main instigator of that phrase, trolls gotta go, because we knew we could push the guy. Trolls gotta go. That is the most funniest one ever, man. Oh, man. Yeah, I do.
Oh yeah.
I remember those days. Yeah. I kind of miss the old times whenever we used to go to some of the good shows they had in DeSoto, Missouri. Kind of miss that. Good old GCW. Mm-hmm. Good old GCW. I miss that. Yeah. I miss those guys a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And what was also awesome was some of the wrestling events we used to go to before that stupid COVID-19 started taking over and all that stupid shit. Their beverages were the best. They sold the best snacks, those soft pretzels, their cheeseburgers, their sodas were good. Oh, man, good stuff. Oh, and those nachos and cheese. I remember that, too. What song is that you're playing there, dude? Oh, Kurt Angle song. Yeah, I remember that old song a lot. I just got a message from somebody here. I mean... Oh, okay. Hang on. This stupid browser on here likes to lag on me every time. It's ridiculous. Here we go. Hang on a second. Yep, we're still alive, I believe.
Yeah, you know, all right.
Yep. I'm typing to a friend here, guys. Hang on a second. Yeah, something else I was trying to go back through. I remember the first time I heard about the World League Wrestling company that's been in Missouri. They did the shows back in my high school where I graduated at. I remember it was they had Bodily Harm, they had Drake Stone, they had All-American Johnny Jett, the drill instructor. And was that your phone ringing? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Unless it's somebody I originally know, I won't answer my phone. That's just how I am. Yeah. Yep, you're watching the live wrestling chat, everyone, and this is all we've been doing is chatting a little bit about our childhood heroes and most of the villains we always liked to hate back when we were children. It was all them things I remember. We would go back saying, oh, I'd like to get in the ring with this little punk and beat him up, blah, blah, blah. Good old days in our childhood. Great memories right there. Definitely great memories.
Mm-hmm.
And I also remember, what else? You remember that one wrestler that would spit that green stuff out?
Yeah.
Pause it real quick. He paid his dues to get in that business. He didn't get no handout. He paid his dues to get in there. That's what he did. A lot of wrestlers had paid their dues. Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
That's all we had. That was all it was done to get in the business. You pay your dues. Yep. Mm-hmm. You know who he, you know who he reminds me of?
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Matt Hardy.
Oh, okay.
Eh?
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, something else, too. I heard they were supposed to have another ladder match or something at SummerSlam, and it's going to be empty arenaed, pretty much. You know what that means? You know those shield sets they have by that, the barracks at ringside? Those plastic, hard plastic? They'll be hitting that a lot. It'll look like a ding. It'll look pretty much like some kind of, what do you call it, where they're trying to put hockey and pro wrestling together. But I don't believe neither of them sports mix either. Hit that hard plastic. Kaboom! Falling off the ladder, that'll be shocking if that happens. That'd be more shocking if they went right through it, though.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man. I'm going to have to watch that if they're having the ladder match. Yeah, that's going to be odd. Oh, I remember watching the on that old TV show Family Matters where they had old Steve Urkel and Carl Winslow that had to take one of his friends' place because they ended up, the real psycho twins they were called, was supposed to go against the Bushwhackers. They ended up drinking that sleepy juice and fell asleep, and the promoters couldn't even wake them up. So Carl Winslow and Steve Urkel had to go in the ring with the Bushwhackers to play the psycho twins, and then it all got messed up when Steve ended up saying that Carl Winslow was a cop, and all the Bushwhackers all flipped out and goes, "We hate cops," sort of thing. And then it went out of control. That was the funniest thing I ever saw on that TV show. Yeah. That's one of the most hilarious shows I ever watched that had pro wrestling in it. Oh, there was another one I saw called Boy Meets World where they had Big Van Vader, who was playing the father of the two boys that was bullying these other boys in high school of some sort. And that ring that they set up, that was just mats on the floor and ropes around it. It wasn't even a professional-like ring. It didn't seem like it. And that ring was kind of looked small. It was kind of like a looks like they had it set like a 12 by 12 structure was how they set it up. Yeah. 12 by 12.
Yeah.
Oh. Me either.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest this time.
Well, yeah, yeah. I've also, yeah. Oh, I was also going to tell everybody who's watching live, I've been watching most of it on Hulu every now and then, usually when I get time. Most of the times I don't even have time to watch Hulu. I got other stuff going on. Well, everybody, looks like we're coming to an end here. And I want to thank everybody for watching us live. And if anybody wants to be a part of our chat program, feel free to contact me and I'll start opening this room up and we can all keep chatting about our childhood heroes and how much fun we've had watching the live wrestling and on TV. So until next time, see y'all later.
Yeah.
Have a good day, everybody.